very sad story that's going to be of concern for a lot of parents. A perfect season for a Michigan high school basketball team ends in tragedy. 16-year-old Wes Leonard, highlighted here, the hometown hero. He and his team celebrating the game-winning shot that he launched. They're hoisting him on their shoulders. A few minutes later, Wes Leonard was dead. He suffered cardiac arrest, and doctors were not able to revive him. It's just one of the many stories we hear about the sudden deaths of young athletes. Let's talk about it with Dr. Manny Alvarez. He is a member of the Fox News Medical A team. Young kid, played a lot of sports, seemed to be in the perfect picture of health.
Breaks my heart. Breaks my heart. This happens. It's happening a lot. I'm going to tell you, it's happening a lot. We have dedicated a whole section at FoxNewsHealth.com just to talk about this. Issues are basically is that athletes have to get a cardiac physical. At the end of the day, you know, we still don't know all the facts on this case. I heard rumors that he was recovering from the flu. We don't know about that. But nonetheless, the typical presentation of his death tells me that this was sudden death, either hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, which is an abnormality of the heart, arrhythmias, you name it. So my advice, as we have said over and over again, if you have a teen person, make sure that you get a cardiac physical, EKG, echocardiogram, family history of heart disease. This is important. The typical physical of a teenager when they play sports is not sufficient, and it has to change.
I was going to say, I remember my high school athletics physicals. They lasted about 5 minutes.
Absolutely. And a lot of parents nowadays, you know, they get a form on the mail that they print from the computer when the kids is going to join a sports. They take it to the pediatrician. Pediatricians just follow the indications of what they have to do. But this is not enough. And we know for a fact that there's underlying cardiac abnormalities that have to be checked, and parents have to get these cardiac physicals.
But Dr. Manny, what questions should parents be asking their student athletes or their children that are athletes about how they're feeling, and what should athletes pay attention to maybe in their body? Would he have felt anything?
Well, look, there are cases where, you know, you have an athlete that perhaps, you know, is feeling sick and he hides those symptoms. That's really something that it shouldn't happen. I'm also talking about dehydration. There's a lot of coaches that pushes these kids to go and play in the heat. We have seen cases of kids collapsing when they don't drink enough water. But those are isolated cases, and parents are pretty well aware of what the kid's condition is. These types of finding, when you have a perfect young kid who just played a terrific game and then just collapses, they cannot revive him, it tells me that this is a cardiac issue. And another point that I want to make is also that in a lot of gyms, they don't necessarily have the right equipment to revive these students. You have to have defibrillators automatic in every place where you're conducting any kind of sports. You have to have the proper equipment to resuscitate, because if you don't do it within 3 or 4 minutes, forget about it.
Well, our hearts go out to the family
Absolutely.
And friends of Wes Leonard, Fenville High School in Michigan. But let's hope some good can come out of this tragedy. FoxNewsHealth.com.
Thank you.
Thank you.